This is the fifth chapter in our Proxmox series. Today, I'm going to give you 6+1 tips on what you should do right after you install Proxmox. Welcome back. As I suspect that you are a hobbyist and perhaps a newcomer to Proxmox, I'll assume that you do not have the paid subscription. And that by itself implies a number of things you should do right off the bat. Number one, disabling the enterprise repository. You can do this either in the web GUI or CLI. In the GUI, navigate to data center node in question. Then in the main window, go to updates and repositories. Select the PVE enterprise list and hit disable. Simple as that. What's noteworthy is that this setting in the menu is tied to only one node or computer, not the whole cluster. But if you have set up a cluster already, you will set this only for one node and the configuration will be spread across the whole cluster. The second option for doing this is via CLI. Edit the etc apt sources list the PVE enterprise list file and comment out the line by adding a hashtag at the beginning of the line. That's it. But remember, this way this setting only applies to one node, even if you have computers joined in a cluster. Number two, enabling no subscription repository. This is the recommended repository for testing and non-production use, according to the definition by Proxmox authors. According to them, its packages are not as heavily tested and validated, but you don't need a subscription key to access the PVE no subscription repository. They do not recommend this for production use, but personally, I found it very stable even for production use. So I use it daily without any major hiccups. Thus, I'm recommending enabling it as well, either through web GUI, in updates, repositories, add, and choose the no subscription repository, or through the CLI by adding this line to the etc apt sources list file. Number three, enabling Debian firmware repository. Starting with Debian Bookworm and Proxmox VE8 accordingly, non-free firmware as defined by the DFSG, the Debian Free Software Guidelines, has been moved to the newly created Debian repository component named non-free firmware. Enable this repository if you want to set up early OS microcode updates or if you need additional runtime firmware files not already included in the pre-installed package PVE firmware. To install packages from this component, run the editor, edit the etc apt sources list, append non-free firmware to the end of each .debian.org repository line, and run apt update. Unfortunately, you won't be able to do this via the web interface. Number four, CPU microcode updates. These updates are intended to fix security vulnerabilities and other serious CPU bugs. These updates can affect CPU performance, but patched microcode is usually still more performant than unpatched microcode, where the kernel itself has to perform mitigations. To run these microcode updates, you need the non-free firmware repository enabled. We did that already in tip number three of this video. So now we need to get the latest available packages with apt-update or use the web interface under node, updates, install the CPU vendor specific microcode package. For Intel CPUs, it's apt install intel-microcode. For AMD CPUs, it's apt install amd64-microcode and reboot the Proxmox host. Number five, installing your favorite CLI tools. It's good practice to install all the small things you're used to employ on a daily basis, like Vim, MC, screen, and so on. Do it. Number six, disabling the subscription nagging message. There are tons of tutorials online on how to do this, but I found out that they're not entirely perfect for Proxmox 8, at least. They kind of break this web GUI add button. So we'll start the usual way by running this command in the CLI. Just copy-paste it from the description. There will be a link to it. It will alter this line, which is totally okay, but this is not enough. If we void this section, then we need to add one more line to this script. We need to call the orgcmd before the else line. Otherwise, it will disrupt the script, and some buttons, like the add button, won't work anymore. Remember to clear the browser cache or restart it so the new JavaScript file is loaded. After that, the nagging message will be gone, thank God. And one bonus tip. Guys, a lot of these steps and more can be easily achieved by using post-installation scripts provided to us by the GitHub user T-Tech. Please do check out his webpage at ttechgithub.io/proxmox. There's a bunch of scripts that make the steps I mentioned earlier a breeze for you. One example for you is the Proxmox VE post-install script, which, quote, provides options for managing Proxmox VE repositories, including disabling the enterprise repo, adding or correcting PVE sources, enabling the no subscription repo, adding the test repo, disabling the subscription nag, updating Proxmox VE, and rebooting the system, end of quote. And it's a one-liner that you'll just copy-paste to Proxmox shell. Look, answer a few questions and it's done. Great stuff. Thank you, T-Tech. I hope I didn't butcher your nick too much. Go check out his other scripts and all the credit belongs to him. Thank you. And that's it. You most certainly can do more, but in my opinion, this is a set of very basic steps almost every one of us should take right after installing Proxmox for the first time, at least. If you find this video or series helpful, please consider hitting that like button and subscribing to my channel. Thank you. Now continue to our next video where I'll show you how to keep your Proxmox up to date, or check out the whole series. Thanks for watching.